What's up, guys? Welcome to this new video. Just one sec. Shit. So as I just said, welcome to this new video. I just got an interview, and if you're watching this, it means that you just got an interview, so congratulations. So in this video, I'll show you my 5-step process to prepare for an interview. And this is the exact same process I used a year ago to land 5 offers within 3 months. And just listen carefully, because those are 5 steps that not a lot of people do. And that's why I stood out from the crowd, and that's why I landed a lot of offers. And make sure you stick around, because at the end of this video, I'll show you my bonus tip that will help you make the best impression possible during an interview. So let's get started. The first step to prepare for an interview is reread the job description and the responsibilities. And this step is overlooked 95% of the time. In fact, I know that a lot of the viewers right now will not implement this new strategy because it just seems easy. But when you get that question, the employer will know which employee read the job description and which employee didn't. And it's simple, because you just apply to, let's say, 10 jobs within 3 days. If you get one interview, well, chances are you won't remember everything that specific company wants. And if you want to get to the second round or the third round or just sign the offer, you will have to tailor your answers to this specific company. And you can't tailor your answers if you don't know really what they want. I remember one time I got this question during a phone interview, and I just answered like that.
Please explain the role in your own words to me, please.
Yeah? Don't do that, be prepared, okay? So what to do if you don't find the job description? Because you can apply for a company, let's say this week, and then they just call you back a month later, and now the job posting is no longer available. So what do you do in that case? Just check out the same role and same job postings in a competitor's firm. So let's take an example. If you applied for a financial analyst role within Bank of America, try to find the exact same role in Wells Fargo, for example. Okay, great. So now you know the job responsibilities and the description by heart. Now, what do you do? Now you will match every job responsibility and requirements to a specific experience you had in the past, or a skill that you currently have. Remember when I said that you have to tailor your answers to this specific companies to their specific responsibilities? Well, this is the time to do it. Companies don't have a clear way to believe you if you say that you're a good leader or that you have good communication skills. So you have to help them by providing clear examples of how you showcase your leadership, for example. If a job posting says something like strong Excel skills, you'll have to think of a previous experience or project you've done in the past where you used Excel with clear examples. Another example, if they say good communication skills and ability to work well in a team environment, think of a time you worked in teams. How did you communicate with them and how did you handle issues? So lesson number one, showcase your skills or your experience by giving clear examples. And this is possible only if you know by heart the job responsibilities and the job requirements. Let's move on to our step number two. Reach out to people on LinkedIn if you have a couple of days before the interview. Well, I just got the interview, right? And it's tomorrow. But let's say that the interview is next week. So I have like 7 days to reach out to people, so that's perfect. But why should you do that? Well, you know, recruiters and even companies in their own websites, they won't tell you all the information that you need to make the best decision for you and your career, right? So if you reach out to past employees or current employees on LinkedIn, you can ask them whatever you want. For example, you could ask them about the hours, the culture, the events, the opportunities, the responsibilities, everything you think will be relevant. Also, something I love is during an interview, I just say like something like, hey, by the way, I know Mike from the financial department.
Okay.
To be honest, I don't know if that makes a great difference for HR people, but it always feels good, eh? And it boosts my self-confidence, so why not?
Okay,
let's move on to our third step. Know who you're interviewing with without being too creepy. I'll say it once more. If you want to tailor your answers to this specific company, besides the job responsibilities and requirements, you'll have to know with whom are you interviewing with, because you want to tailor your answers to this specific person. You're not gonna talk the same way with a manager or a partner as an HR or a recruiter, right? And once you have a name, you could stalk them, but not in a creepy way. A quick rule of thumb is when you find information on LinkedIn or Twitter, it's safe to bring it up during an interview if you see fit. But if you find information elsewhere, let's say Facebook, that may not be a good idea to come up with information about his or her past vacation with their kids and their grandmas and whatever. Another rule here is to look for similarities. Maybe you studied at the same school, at the same university. Maybe you had a mutual connection. Maybe you worked at the same place a couple of years ago, or I don't know. Maybe you both like cruises. And talking about cruises, if you just saw it on Twitter that she went on a cruise and that you love cruises, well, you can bring that up during an interview, for example. Because the key here is to start talking during the interview about stuff unrelated to the job and to create that connection that I was talking about, because it is the only way that you have to stand out. Because I'll give you an example. Who will you remember? The one who talked about your passion about cruises, let's say, or the other one who said that he's a great leader without providing any example? You see? So if you connect with the other person, you'll just be better than anyone else. Next tip is asking the recruiter about the format of the interview. Personally, I haven't done it because every interview that I got, I knew that it was behavioral or case or whatever. But a lot of time you just get the interview and you don't know if it's a behavioral interview or is it a case, is it a group interview. So make sure you know it. And it's only normal because you won't prepare for an interview the same way if it's a behavioral or if it's a case interview. If it's a behavioral interview, you will prepare questions such as, what are your weaknesses? Tell me about yourself. Tell me about a time you worked in teams. But if it's a case interview, you will have to prepare in a different way. And my advice to you, if you have a case interview coming up, you should buy a book like this one. It's called Case in Point. It's a bestseller on Amazon, and it gives you all the examples of questions that you may get during a case interview. And those are like brain teasers questions. It's not always logical. And this book gives you the thinking process on how to best answer those type of questions. Let me read an example. You see, how many smartphones were sold in the US last year? So I won't give you the answer to this question because that's not the subject of this video, but if you have a case interview coming up, or if you're interested in consulting, you may want to check that out, and I'll put a link below if you're interested. I know that reading it helped me tremendously during my PwC interview because I had a group case interview. So let's move on to our last step just before I share with you my bonus tip. And this step is preparing TGQ questions.
But Matty, what's a TGQ questions?
Well, a TGQ question is that's a good questions question. Yeah, don't question it. I had to find a name for this step, so please bear with me. So, as I said, TGQ stands for that's a good question, and that's the effect you'll have on the interviewer. You know when you feel proud because you just asked a good question and the other person says, wow, that's a good question. You know, that feeling, well, you want to get this feeling every time you get an interview. Because asking basic questions may give a bad image of yourself, because questions can say a lot about your personality, about how you think, about your priorities. So here's a list of questions that I love to ask during interviews. So let's start. What's a challenge you currently are facing in your role? This question reveals how you care about what is going on in the company and that you may be willing to help and go outside of your comfort zone. Number two, what are some things the team does together? And this question reveals how you don't only care about your salary and your benefits, and that you care also about others and your coworkers, and that you want to create bonds. We all know that stronger bonds lead to better results when working together. And last question, what can I expect in my first year at Company X? And this question reveals that you are way ahead, that you're not only thinking about getting the job and getting started, you are carefully evaluating your options and you want to know where are you going with this job. Great questions, right? Yeah, you can use them, and I'll advise you to use them if you want to make a good impression. And speaking of good impression, let's move on to our bonus tip, and that is any of your clothes. Now, I won't tell you how to dress because I assume you know how to dress for an interview, but I want to talk about colors because a year ago, like I said, when I was preparing for interviews, I wanted everything to be perfect. So I even researched colors during interview because I knew that colors had a psychological effect on humans, so I wanted to stack all the odds on my favor, and you should too. I remember reading a good article on monsters that we'll read together, so let's see it together. So I'll put a link in the description of this video, but this article's title is "What Color Suit Should You Wear During a Job Interview?" And it speaks about all the colors, all the psychological effects that you may have on the interviewer if you wear, let's say, blue, gray, black, red, or white. But as a quick rule of thumb, you should choose solids over patterns, choose neutrals over bright, and bright should only be used as an add-on. And I'll give you an example of the suit that I bought or that I wore during my job interviews a year ago. So you see, I chose a blue suit, a navy blue suit, because it gives an image of someone who is in control according to Munsters. Okay? And blue conjures up calm, stability, trust, truth, confidence, and security. And those are the qualities that you want to show off during an interview, right? I chose white because it's just a safe bet, like Munster said, and it's just simple, precise, and it's neutral. Also, a red tie tends to stand out during an interview, right? Because not a lot of people put ties. I don't know why. So, you are now ready for your interview. I hope that your next interview will go well. If you listen to this video and if you implement these 5 tips, I'm sure that you'll increase your chance of signing that offer, and good luck on that. The question that remains before I let you go is, what do you do exactly after you finish that interview? And that is sending a thank you note. But not any thank you note. You have to send the best thank you note possible to stand out from the other applicants. And if you don't see this video coming up next or in the YouTube cards here or here, I could never remember. Well, make sure you subscribe to get notified when this video comes up, I hope next week. Let me know in the comment section below, what tip are you going to implement first? Are you going to prepare TGQ questions? Are you gonna buy a new suit? Or are you gonna reach out to people on LinkedIn? So let me know. If you like this video or if you got any value from it, hit the like button, subscribe so that you won't miss any future videos that will help you land your future job, and share it with a friend, maybe that is going through interviews right now. So I'll talk to you in the next video. Ciao.